Until William Leif Robinson shot down his Zeppelin in September 1916, the huge airships had been bombing us with impunity. Afterwards, the spell was broken, and never again would the German Air Force regard London as a soft target. William, remembered as a cheerful chap, was just 21 when he was awarded the Victoria Cross, the only VC ever given for action in this country. Overnight, he became a national hero. The souvenir sellers spawned matchbox holders and dozens of other commemorative objects, and no patriotic mantelpiece was complete without William's portrait. Also in the collection being sold, and proving that fact can beat fiction any day, the dented halfpenny which saved William's life when he was hit by shrapnel in another Dice with Death. But it was his exploits in an experimental Blériot plane which stirred the imagination of an empire, and proved that the Zeppelin wasn't invulnerable.
And when it had happened, of course, the whole country went mad. That weekend of the 2nd and 3rd of September 1916, the following day after the Zeppelin had crashed at Cuffley in Hertfordshire, there were 10,000 people converged on the site.
The collection is being sold by William's niece to raise money for children with leukemia. She'll miss it, but reckons that action is more important than things.
It's a treasure, but a treasure is an inanimate object, and I do think that children that have always been my interest should be helped as much as possible, especially sick children, because I think it's a great deal of bad luck and misery for them to have cancer. And if we could beat this to give them a future life, then that's marvellous.
The collection includes a hairbrush complete with hidden compass, designed to give airmen a chance to escape if captured. It didn't work for William, and when he was later shot down, he spent long months as a prisoner. His strength was worn down, and he died in the influenza epidemic which claimed millions of lives after the war. Christie's hoped to raise between £60,000 and £80,000 for charity, a fitting memorial for a hero. Paul Arsman, Thames News.